guys, and welcome to Art Project Number 1 Week. The focus of Art Project 1 is the elements and the principles, the elements of art and the principles of design. So your grade will consist of 3 parts: the image or the photo of your finished project, your project proposal idea, and your self-reflection. Or if you're taking the test, it will be your project proposal, Google form filled out, and your test score. You will be required to submit a project proposal idea in a Google form to me, the teacher, as a part of your grade. If you choose the unit test, you still have to say that you are going to choose the test. So first, I'm going to show you where to find things, and then I'm going to go through a couple examples from past years. And eventually I will show you how to turn it in. But before we start, just know that your due date is October 4th. With art projects, I always give you a whole week just to work on it, and then it's not due until the following week. So you're going to work on your art project September 23rd to 27th, and then we'll move on. We'll learn about new things the next week, but it's not due until October 4th. So you have plenty of time to dedicate some time to your art project if you want. Okay, so here you are in your, on the class page. You can see over here, you have all of your options. You're gonna click on Assignments Resources, like usual. You're gonna go to Module 1, and then this fancy little chart I make here, this table, everything here is a link. So you can click on this. This takes you to Week 4, Art Project 1. There's your checklist, and the Assignments folder over here. Can see all of the different things that you have to do this week. So if you want to get the overview and read the lesson plans on what you're supposed to do this week from day to day, they're here. So right now it's Monday, the first day of Art Project Week, and there you go. Today you're supposed to watch videos, then you are supposed to read through the description, and then you're supposed to watch this video, and then review your vocabulary before you take your vocabulary test. So that's how you know what you're supposed to do every day this week. And then down here, you have the different options for your art project. So basically, you have to decide whether you're going to do a project or whether you're just going to take the test. The test options right here, and the project option is right here. So here's the description. Don't pay attention to this yet. But here's the description, all the different options that you can choose, the rubric of how you will be graded. And you can see that taking the test is an option for this art project grade. So there's a little bit of a description here. Your project is due October 4th. But basically, if you choose a project, it can be any one of these that are listed, or it could be a choose your own. And when you're ready, you're going to write a text submission. It's going to be your self-reflection or artist statement. And I'll give you more information about that in a little bit. And then the actual pictures of your finished project you're going to, or the file, whatever you want to do, you're going to browse your computer and attach it there. And then when you're ready, click submit. And then that is how I will grade it. The test option is here. And before you take the test option, make sure that you take the Unit 1 test in the OLS to prepare. And then I have some demonstration videos. There's this one, and then I'm going to add the still life video. I have that linked in other places too, but me doing the different project options and demonstrating it to you. And then you have the links to your vocabulary to practice a couple more times, and here's the link to your vocabulary test for this unit. So that's how to find everything.
Let's talk about the individual project options now.
Okay, option one is the abstract painting. So if you're choosing the abstract painting, your mission is to select a series of complementary or analogous colors, so that's either opposite colors or neighbor colors, remember from what we learned, and make a composition from it. So you can do it in a lot of different styles. You can do a Vasily Kandinsky music composition. You can do a splatter painting in the style of Jackson Pollock. You can do a pour painting, acrylic pour painting, and you can do a Mark Rothko minimalist painting. Let me show you what I mean. So abstract art, we don't have to go through all of this, but abstract art is basically okay, so Kandinsky, Vasily Kandinsky created music-inspired art with geometric elements. He used a lot of colors, and he often assigned colors, shapes to musical elements. If you do this, I would prefer it be a classical piece of music, and it really shouldn't look like anything. So the idea is to assign musical elements to like a shape or a color or something like that. You can also do a concentric circles painting, but here's what I did. So I used the song Rhapsody in Blue by George Gershwin, and here's that song. And as the music was playing, I tried to create a painting that sort of represented the sounds. So how it goes louder and quieter, that's what I was trying to do with this painting. It also kind of sounds like little spirals to me. So it's kind of how I did mine. Let me show you a few student examples. So you have this one. This is by Alyssa G. She did a Kandinsky painting. You have Hannah Adler. She did a spiral in the style of Kandinsky. And then Chessa C did a Kandinsky style painting with shapes and forms. So that's a kind of an example of what you can do. Pick a classical song that you like. It doesn't have to be old classical. It could be, you know, like Lindsey Stirling or something like that, and create a painting based on that, the sound there. Jackson Pollock is your next option for abstract painting. So Jackson Pollock was more interested in the action or movement of actually painting than what it looked like. So it really just is splatters. It's trying to make you feel movement. So if you do this, I want you to check with your parents and make sure that you do it outside so you're not splattering paint inside of your house, because no matter how neat you try to be, it will not be neat. And definitely water down the paint for optimal splattering. If you use thick paint, it won't splatter. So there's an example. Here's what we did for an art outing. So this is art that PA Virtual Kids did with me. This was the orange one was my example, and then this is what we did together. We took the painting outside, we put up a drop cloth, and we threw paint, different paint colors at it until we liked what we saw. So it really doesn't take very long, but you can sort of experiment with different shapes and colors. You can see each one looks different. Here's an example from Matthew S. that he did a splatter painting in art class. Here is Stephanie. She also did a splatter painting last semester. And then the last one is the acrylic pour painting. So I included a video in your lesson plans that tells you how to do the mixture. So you start with acrylic paint. You might need more than what the OLS sent you. So you might have to go get some acrylic paint, but you don't have to get the expensive stuff. Just they have stuff at Walmart that's like $1.50 a bottle. So you mix Mod Podge and glue and water and follow this recipe that I included, and you can do things that look like this. There are really so many ways to do that. That's why I didn't tell you a particular way, because there are about thousands and thousands of videos on YouTube on different techniques with this. But basically, the idea is you mix paint with these different things. So Mod Podge, glue, water. You could also do cornstarch, I think, if you don't want to do Mod Podge. And you basically put a bunch of paint into cups and you pour it over a canvas. So this is also something you want to do outside. We talked about Emma Lindstrom, an artist, in the first couple lessons. Here's an example of her acrylic pour painting. She goes in, she pours it, and then she goes in and she sort of edits some things. Here's another example of what it could look like. It's like the chemical reaction of the mixture doesn't, it makes the paint not mix together. So you kind of get the different paint colors. They don't merge into one color, and then you can do cool things like this. So I think these cells, they call them, are made by blowing on the painting with a straw. Here's a couple examples of what students have done. This is Shannon V. She did a purple acrylic pour painting. This one didn't have a name, but it's awesome. So this was from last semester. And then this was Abigail. She did a pour painting as well. So you have to select complementary or analogous colors again. So either opposite colors or neighbor colors. And you could try an acrylic pour painting. The last abstract painting is Mark Rothko. He did block painting, so he did these big blocks of color, and you can see some examples here. Mark Rothko was interested in pure colors, so my tip would be use lots of paint. If you're going to use a lighter color, start with white and then add the color to it. So that's a couple of examples. Here is your second option. So this is the challenge option. I always have a little bit of a harder one if you really want to challenge yourselves. So here's my video. You can also find that in Blackboard. But your painting must contain a set of complementary colors and two or more elements of art. So you have to have an opposite colors, and you have to be able to tell me what elements or principles of art your painting has. So here's some classic examples. Here's my video that I did, but what the end result was this. So I go through how to paint this in my video. Here's me working on it, and you can see what I was painting from. A still life is basically just a arrangement of objects not moving. So it could be fruit, it could be whatever you want. Here's some student examples. So here's one student example from last semester. They didn't include a name, but it's awesome. You can see the complementary colors, blue and orange and red and green. So those are your opposite colors. Here is another one from last semester. So this is an arrangement of objects. It's a tea set. So that looks really cool. You can see the picture and then the finished result. Here's an awesome one too. This is from Gracie LSC. It's like a teapot, flowers, and a candle holder, but I just love the colors that she used. And then here's one from last semester. This is Brenna J. She did flowers. So you can see complementary colors, red and green, opposites. And she did a really, really cool composition with her still life. Just flowers in a vase, but it turned out really cool. And then here's Julian R. He did the Day of the Dead. You can see the complementary colors, purple and yellow, or opposites. And he decided to do a still life like this, a little bit more of a different take on it. And then here's one of my favorites too. This is Aaron H. He did an American still life, and he did like a burger and fries for lunch. But he did, you can see red and green are his opposite colors here. So you could really take that in a lot of directions. You don't have to do a painting. This one is colored pencil. If you want to try out the painting, that's what the video is. But you could really, you don't have to go out and buy paint. You don't have to spend a lot of money on supplies. You can do in any medium that you want. Okay, the next project option is the photography project. So I want you to go on a photography scavenger hunt to find the elements of art and principles of design in everyday things around you. So you don't have to go outside. You could do this in your house. Refer to your list of elements and principles. So there's 14 total. There's 7 elements and 7 principles. So I want you to pick 10. So it doesn't matter what combination of elements and principles you pick. You just have to go around and take pictures and then be able to tell me which element or principle it is showing. So I would do this in a PowerPoint presentation. You can upload the PowerPoint presentation in the self-reflection Google form to turn it in. Here's an example. So this is a student from one of my semesters. Her name is Destiny, and she did the photography project. And you can see this, I don't know why I cut this off, but she did have an S here. Emphasis, line, movement, space. These are her elements and principles of art that she chose, and she took these pictures. Now,
You might say, did she go to the beach in the middle of the school year? If you have pictures that you took that you want to use for this, that's absolutely fine. She went out and she took some, and then she filled in what she didn't have with pictures that she's taken before. You can see this shows movement. This shows emphasis because she's wearing a different color against a plain wall. You can see line here. She's like the line in the candy boxes and the line in the blinds and space, positive and negative space. So really cool. You can have a lot of fun with this, and it's very interpretive. You just have to have one element or principle of art for each picture that you choose, and you need at least 10 slides in your PowerPoint. The next project option is a sketch of a famous work. So I want you to choose a famous piece of art that we covered in Unit 1 to sketch in your sketchbook. You can take a picture of it, or you can scan it. You should choose from the slides and examples in the OLS or the videos or slides that I used in class. My example that I did here in the slide, I will also post it in Blackboard, but basically I took Four Dancers by Edgar Degas and I sketched it for you guys. So I started with this and then I kind of walk you through everything that I did to create it. So you'll find that in Blackboard on YouTube and also posted in the announcements. So my finished result ended up, where did I put it? Right here. So I just kind of show you little details of it. I did it with my iPad, so it's pastel, but it's kind of around, you know, it's similar to what it would be like if I did it on paper. It's just a little bit easier of a video to watch. So you can watch that if you want. You can pick anything that's in the slides, anything that we talked about, and try to create it on your own. Here are some student examples. So this is by Olivia T. She did American Gothic. That was in your OLS. Here is a girl with a pearl earring, done by a student named Kelly. And here's Sarah E. also did girl with a pearl earring, but she zoomed in a little bit closer. You don't have to do a project. You could do an essay if you wanted. So you could do an artist profile or biography. You are going to need five paragraphs. So you're going to need to start with a basic summary of the artist and their role in art history, anyone or anything that has influenced artist artworks, a summary of the artist's artistic philosophy, a description of at least three notable works, an analysis of the artist's works to according to the elements and principles of art, and your personal opinion. So if you like writing, you can do an essay. You certainly don't have to. Or you can choose your own. So any one of these projects, if you want to take it in a different direction, if you think of a different project, the only thing is you have to clear it with me if you're going to choose your own, and it has to relate to the elements and principles of art, because that's the whole point of the project. So that's the whole theme of the project. So whatever you want to do, you just have to make sure that you clear it with me. I'm usually pretty open to things. I usually don't say no. If anything, I will just use your idea and, you know, kind of expand on it, make it cooler, take it a little bit deeper. Okay, so you might be wondering how you turn in your project. I will show you that now. For those of you that would like to take the test, I will show you how to find that in Blackboard and complete that.